Okay, hello and welcome back to today's video. In today's video, we are going to learn about how to see the center of gravity, or generally we call that a CG, of the entire assembly, okay, of the complete assembly in different conditions, in different combination, if the assembly is having multiple state in which the assembly can be created. So we need to see the center of gravity for the entire assembly and also how to check relatively center of gravity for a respective part. So that is what we are going to see in today's video. Now, I have got immense support and appreciation for this video, which I have created last time, that was related to assembly arrangement. So if you haven't watched that particular video, I would really appreciate if you go ahead and watch that video as well. So here, if I go in arrangement, I have already created this particular assembly with an arrangement, which is an open arrangement and a close arrangement. So if you want to try something, something similar of your own, you can always go there and check this particular video and you can try that as well. Okay, so let's begin with creating a center of gravity, first of all, for the assembly and how to check that as well. Now, what I need to actually do is, for this particular assembly, I need to know the balancing point. Okay, the center of gravity will help me to do that. Now, center of gravity is generally a point where the entire assembly is safely or can be safely balanced, okay, at that particular point in normal working conditions. So what I want to do is, I want to figure out the center of gravity for this entire arm motion structure. And I want to exclude this part, okay, part number one from the list, okay, and part number two from the list. Now, first of all, if you have created an assembly and if you want to figure out the center of gravity for that assembly, I would recommend you to do this thing. First, before opening the assembly, go to assembly load options, okay, and then here you have to load all components with the option of fully load. Okay, make sure the option of fully load is selected and then only load all the components so that you will have the complete data structure of entire element. So here, if I click on the assembly now here I have all the components which are fully loaded. Okay, you can see in the part navigator here on the right side, okay, this save icon is available for all the components. So that means everything is fully loaded. Okay, now here what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to this assembly tab and I'll go to arrangement. Let us first see the close arrangement first, like this arrangement. And I want to see the center of gravity for this arrangement. Now, I am going to teach you a way of, looking at center of gravity in which you will be not able to like only see, okay, but you will be able to actually figure out where the center of gravity is and also in different conditions, okay. So here what we are going to do is, let's try to find out the center of gravity for this tub, okay. So I want to figure out the center of gravity for this one of the major component inside the assembly, that is this tub. So I'm going to go to Analyze tab and here I'm going to click on the first tool, that is Measure. And Measure is a really powerful tool, okay, which has been included in the newer version of NX. And this is much better than what we used to get in the previous version of NX. So here I'm going to click on Measure. I'm just resetting this command so that all my settings are by default. Okay, now here in the Measurement command, I'm going to select Object if I'm going to check the center of gravity for one single component. Okay, so here I'm going to select Object. Now here in Selection Filter, I'm going to select Solid Body, so that I am looking for only solid bodies, or my mouse is only selecting solid bodies for now, okay, and I'll click on this particular object. Now when I click on this particular object, that is the tub of this particular assembly, I guess various parameters, okay. And why I'm getting these parameters, because these are related to a solid body. I'm getting the surface area, the volume, the center of mass, which is your CG, the mass, the weight, the moment of inertia, and various other informations you are getting. So here we are, we want to have a look at center of mass, and what I'm getting is a point coordinate location of the center of mass in mm, and that is fine. But what I want to do is I want to construct a point there. I need a point to be physically present at the location of the center of mass. So if you notice right in this line here, you have three icons. Okay, especially for center of mass, you have one more icon. Okay, so here the first icon is creates an associative measure feature, okay, and save the expression. So here if I click on this particular icon, it will create an associative measurement feature. So that will be, there inside the memory of NX, okay. And if I go in expression by pressing Control E, I'll be able to see that value, okay. And here this particular option will create an associative geometry, okay, will create an associative geometry to the measure feature. So what this is going to do is going to create a measure feature, and this will create a geometry where this particular feature is located. So if you don't turn this thing on, and if you only turn this thing on, it will be a non-associative measurement. Now the problem with non-associative measurement is it will not get updated as and when you move the part around. So here I want to keep both of these on, okay? And then I'm going to click OK for my measurement. So once I click OK for my measurement, I'll go to Tool and go to Expression. And here, if I go down, you will be able to see P173, something like that. It might be different for your case scenario. And you can see we have the coordinates over here. And this is derived from measurement. Okay, this is derived from measurement. Now, what we are going to do is, I want to see visually. So if I rotate this thing around, you can visually see here in the center somewhere, okay, this kind of double pin symbol. So basically, this is the point of measurement. Okay, so this is the point from where the measurement is taken. Basically, this is a point, exactly the CG of this particular part. To make it look better, I can right click, go to rendering style and choose static wireframe so that it will be easily visible for me, although if like the entire assembly is also selected. Now, what I want to do next is, I want to see the center of gravity for the entire assembly, excluding some components here, like component number one, I don't want. Component number two, I don't want to see. Okay, so I'm just hiding. Okay, component 1 and 2, which I don't want it to participate inside my center of gravity calculation. I want to see the center of gravity for this entire thing. So what I'm going to do, again, I'm going to go to analysis. And because this time I'm going to select more than one solid body, I'm going to select this option called object set. Okay, it is very important to select this option, object set. And then here I'm going to select solid body again in the filter, okay, in the type of filter. So in place of no selection filter, I'm going to select solid body here. And then either you can press Control A to make your selection faster. I'm doing the same. So I'm pressing Control A to make my selection faster. And the body which are hidden will not be a part of that set. Okay. And again, you can see the center of mass point. And I want to create an associative measurement feature and also an associative measurement point. Okay. Once I decide this two again, similarly, I'll click OK. And here this time we are getting the center of gravity somewhere over here. Okay. Now let's say I want to include this two. You know, I want to include the back portion as well as the pin. And again, I want to check. So I do repeat the same command. I'll go to object set. Now software remembers my selection. It was solid body for selection filter. I'll just press Control A again. Again, I'll activate the associative measurement feature as well as the associative measurement point. So once I activate both of them, again, I'll click OK. And this time my center of gravity is here. Okay, somewhere in the middle, which is really nice because this thing is going to get mounted to the body itself. Now, this center of gravities are when the body is in the state, in this closed state. I can go to the assembly tab. I can go to arrangements. I can double click on open arrangement. And now you can see the center of gravity point changes. Now, this is the center of gravity for the tub. This is the center of gravity for my entire part, excluding the front portion. And this is the center of gravity for the entire thing. Okay, so if I just highlight or try to select. Okay, so this is a center of body or center of mass for the entire thing. So this is how in NX you can easily figure out, okay, the center of mass irrespective of which version you are using. If you are using any version from where the new measure tool is available, like from NX 12, okay, you will be able to figure this thing out. So I hope you like this video. I hope you understood something about, you know, how to get the measurement out from the body itself. Okay, and I hope this is particularly helpful. So thank you very much for watching. Have a great day ahead.